So I got an opportunity to go to Nagoya, Japan for a month and collaborate with a production team there who were experimenting with virtual reality 360 videos. I don't know if you guys are aware, but Facebook recently bought Oculus. Oculus became a huge virtual reality company from Kickstarter. This young, like, brilliant kid made it in his garage. But, you know, since Oculus and since Facebook bought Oculus, it's blown up, at least in that tech circle, where now filmmakers and tech people are collaborating together to create VR content. Long story short, I got an opportunity to go to Nagoya and learn from these guys how to shoot 360 video, which shooting the project in Nagoya, I picked up this device here, which is literally a cube with six GoPro HERO4s attached to each side, which I then put on a monopod. Once we shoot the footage, you get, you know, basically six angles of a shot that covers 360. Then I import it into Kolor Autopano Stitch, which is the program I use to then take the six footages, stitch it together, and it creates a 360 spherical dome of the footage we shot. And then once you shoot it, then you need either a head mount display like this, which is the Samsung Gear VR. And so what this does is it basically takes the Samsung Note 4 and you can slide it into the front of it. And from the Oculus app that is available, you can download and stream content into your headset unit. So yeah, I mean, I think the VR stuff that, you know, in the 80s, I mean, actually before that, from 60s till recently, that's always been kind of like sci-fi mythology in film and TV, is finally catching up. The technology is catching up where we can actually viably shoot the content and distribute it. I mean, there's some limitations. It's still like the first generation of the technology at work. So, you know, it's not really out for mass consumption, but people like me and programmers, Unity programmers specifically, you know, we're doing a lot of R&D now to figure out all the kinks and get it to a point where it'll be consumer ready, which will probably be around 2017, 2018. So we did a cool kind of drive, a ride along shot through downtown LA. We had a friend that worked at a classic car rental spot. So we got a nice Cadillac convertible. So what we did was we literally got a C-stand, put it in the back seat, sandbagged the hell out of it to give us some stability because we couldn't afford to put it on some kind of gimbal or gyroscopic, you know, system. So we just sandbagged the hell out of it as much as we could, on top of which then we put the 360 camera. And then so that allowed us to basically just get 360 coverage with wherever we rode, as well as getting movement, which is hard to do with 360. It wasn't perfect. There was some shakiness, and you'll notice if you do 360, when you get shakiness in the shot, it makes the stitching really difficult between the six cameras because then you basically have six independent shots kind of shaking around and it's hard for the stitch to stay locked. That's very technical, but that's a big problem that we're dealing with now at this point is how to eliminate the stitch lines, which is, if you really watch it, it's always there, the lines between the cameras, and then also how to eliminate or not eliminate, but how to further get movement in the shots. Because with 360, you know, there's limitations where obviously if a cameraman's holding the camera, if the viewer looks back, they're gonna see the cameraman. So that, you know, obviously that breaks the fourth wall. So that's an issue. So there's more and more like sophisticated systems that are coming out. Drones is a very popular method of shooting 360, because then it does eliminate the cameraman, but then when you look up, you still have the propellers that you're dealing with. And then the resolution is another limitation, is because you're dealing with so much data, to compress it to a point where it'll actually be viewable, you get quite a heavy compression on the video itself. So these are all very nerdy technical things that we're figuring out in the R&D stage. Luckily, no one's really, the general public isn't really hip to it yet. So it's allowing us to just figure all these things out.